Welcome to OUTsurance. All calls are recorded for your benefit. For a quote on a personal vehicle or personal assets, press 1 now.
OUTsurance, you are speaking to Duke. How may I help you?
Duke. What's your surname, Duke?
Madikizela.
Craig here. I'm looking for a quote on some personal items.
Okay, sir. What type of items are we talking about?
Personal items. So
your household contents, I believe.
That's it. You could call it that, yeah.
No problem. And how much are they worth in total?
I don't know. Do you guys have like an average amount that you insure things for?
Okay, the minimum amount is 50,000.
Look, can I just give you the list of my personal items?
Not necessarily. This is how I can do it. If you would lose all your personal items today, and then I give you 50,000, would you be able to buy all of them back?
Yes.
So 50,000 is enough for you?
Yes.
No problem, okay?
Okay, because look, what I'm insuring is my toothbrush.
Yeah.
My Colgate toothpaste.
Yes.
A radio.
Yes.
2 packs of cigarettes.
Yes.
Slippers.
Yes.
And a towel. That's what I need insured.
Okay. That's what you need insured.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay, just stay with me for a couple of seconds.
What's the problem?
No, there's no problem. There's absolutely no problem. What? Okay.
Hello?
Yes, I'm still here. I'm still here.
These are my personal belongings.
Yes, I fully understand, and we take them in very high regard.
Yeah. So okay.
What's going to happen is that, let's say for example your toothbrush goes missing. Okay.
Yes.
We're going to replace the toothbrush.
Yes.
Tell me something, sir, if you don't mind me asking. Your toothpaste and your toothbrush and your towel and everything.
Yes.
Where do you keep them?
In my cell.
In your?
My cell.
Your cell?
Yeah.
What type of cell is that?
I'm in jail.
In jail?
Yes.
So as you're speaking now, you are in jail?
Yes.
No problem. You want to ensure your stuff that you have inside your jail cell?
Yes. You see, because there's a lot of theft that happens here in jail.
Yes, I can imagine. I can imagine.
And a pack of cigarettes to you might be 30 bucks. But in jail, it's 1,000 rand.
1,000 rand?
That's how much it goes for. That's why you see it's so valuable for me.
Yes.
So I need to insure it because I've got a bit of money on the outside. And I'm here for 15 years, so I need it for 15. And then if I have a no-claim bonus,
yes,
like for 15 years,
yes,
then does this apply? Can I get a payout?
I want to tell you from the onset. And you know, sir, it might also be very difficult for you to insure your stuff in jail. You know, I must be very honest with you.
Just because what I did doesn't mean I have no right to insurance.
Definitely, sir. Definitely. I'm certainly not disputing that.
Just because I killed 3 people.
You did what?
Wow.
Just because I killed 3 people.
You killed 3 people?
Yeah.
Yes. I suppose. What a point there. You killed 3 people.
Yeah.
Hey, do you mind if I go sort of consult about the situation that we are having? You are putting in front of me, sir? Oh.
If I make a claim and you guys say we need to send an assessor, look, it might be a bit of a problem.
I fully understand. When are you coming out of jail?
I got 15 years.
15 years?
Yeah. Like, your outsurance is for people on outside of jail. And, like, insurance, maybe you got something for people inside of jail.
You've made a very good point there, I must say. So how would you like me to help you, say? No, look, you want to insure your toothbrush, your toothpaste, your towel, your pack of cigarettes, and your slippers.
And my radio.
And your radio, yes. How can I forget that?
Oh, I also need to insure my orange jumpsuit.
The gel suit?
Yes.
You know, to be very honest with you, sir, I don't think you'd have to take it that far, because I know if something happens to you, you'd certainly get a new one. You understand what I'm saying?
You get one a year. Yeah. Oh, also, I need to just insure my shank.
Could you please just simplify that? What? A shank.
My shank, yeah. I made it, it's a knife that I made out of a big pen.
A knife?
That I made out of a big pen.
Cool.
Priceless.
To be honest, sir, I honestly doubt we can help you, sir.
Oh.
You know, with all sincerity, I honestly, honestly doubt we can assist you in this regard, sir. You're in jail. That's obviously not nice. And you want to ensure the very important things in your immediate environment that you own.
Yes.
And taking into serious consideration the fact that, you know, the environment you are in is a very high risk environment.
Well, look, if you need to know of my what I call my apartment, it's got burglar bars.
Yes, I
know you guys need to know if a house is secured with burglar bars. I promise you, it's got burglar bars.
It must be a lot of burglar bars.
Yeah, it's impregnable.
It's certainly.
You nobody will get in.
It's certainly not willingly.
I've got 8-foot-high wall around, barbed wire, got another fence, and I've got about 60 armed guards. So, tell me this isn't a safe bet for you guys.
I think it is so safe that you might not even need insurance, sir. all these items of yours, sir.
Could I call you if they scale my toothbrush then? Seeing as the insurance can't help me. And if they scale my toothbrush, can I call you?
Call me.
And say, hey, Duke, I need another toothbrush. Can you help a brother out?
I really don't mind. Especially for you.
Aww. I'll introduce you to my cellmate as well.
No. We don't have to take it that far.
Yeah, he's a nice guy.
No.
He loves me. He loves me.
He loves me.
Yeah.
I'm sure he does.
He'll love you too.
Oh.
Love me.
He's got very soft hands.
Oh.
Soft what?
Hands.
Hands.
Hmm.
He's got soft hands.
Yeah.
My word. No, I suppose there are people with soft hands. Gee, I don't know what to say.
Look, all I'm saying is that if my toothbrush gets scaled, will you, Duke Marikizela, employee of our insurance, citizen of South Africa, give me a new one?
Certainly, yes. Definitely, I can bring you a toothbrush. I would love you to have many toothbrushes at this stage, if it means so much to you. And, you know,
it is C-Max, cell block C,
yes.
Cell number 947.
947, yes.
And put it for attention, cell mate, Darren Wackhead Simpson.
Ha 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 Oh, I never thought this day would come.
Duke!
No, I'm lost. I'm actually lost for words. Gee, I've never panicked so much.
Alright, Duke Marikizela, employee of Adsurance, as the employee of the year.
In fact,
call center operator of the year, my friend.
Yes, high five.
Lovely.